Okay, Mr. Essay, I say, prepare to be written!
I'm the writer, as you probably can tell if you've watched any of my scripted videos. Still, today I wanted to talk about something I came to realize the more media I consumed, regardless of form. There are, obviously with exceptions to the rule, two styles of storytelling that you come across, opposite to each other, but both somehow with unique strengths and problems. There are the epic tales, planned in excruciating detail from the first page to the last word or panel. Everything each character does and experiences has meaning, be it in action or personal growth. You always know exactly as much as you need to know at any given moment, and upon rewatching, the show gets even better now that you know the big picture of things. On the other side, there's the work born from one idea, one concept, one thing someone thought was neat, and so it was given life, allowed to grow in any direction the tale took it to, sometimes hitting gold or sometimes a dead end. Infinite potential, but highly unpredictable of success or quality. To give an example, I'm gonna take two shows I watched recently, and well, I think they have a nice contrast to each other. The first is a rewatch of one of my favorite shows from my childhood to teenage years, the greatest Western action cartoon, Avatar: The Last Airbender.
But I believe Aang can save the world.
Secondly, let's call it the divisive last season of Game of Thrones.
You are my queen. I don't know what else I can say.
I was taken aback by Avatar, just how much duality and role reversal is in the dynamic from Aang to Zuko, how the first two episodes define the world and characters effortlessly, without losing a sense of childish fun.
Please, come closer.
What is it?
Will you go penguin sledding with me?
Sure.
The world building and perfectly choreographed fight scenes, I could go on, but the point is, the series gives me the feeling that everything was planned out. Every little thing a character says and does fits their personality or is used to develop the very same. Game of Thrones, you probably have seen and read enough about what went wrong, and we have no books to compare to, a lot of the frustrations directed at the writers. Justified or not, it is the best example of an open storytelling style.
So that one, I was already writing, so that one didn't make much sense to me, although I could see the sense of it. But the second one, you must finish what you write. That was very important to me at an early age, because I was constantly not finishing what I liked. I was buried in fragments for precisely the reasons that Robin talked about. I would have this story idea, and it would exist in my head in this platonic perfection. Yeah. And I would sit down to try to capture it, and I'd be writing on it and wrestling it and writing with these words, and then I would look at it, and it was not the beautiful dream city that I had imagined. It was this kind of slum of words, and no, I didn't get it right. It was horrible, and I'd get like halfway through it, and then I'd have another idea, and that would exist in platonic perfection and would seem so much more attractive than this mess that I had half written on paper. So I'd put the mess aside, and I'd start a new story.
That is not to say that the story has no beginning or ending or goal or anything along those lines. George likes to treat Westeros like a personal garden. He plants characters like flower seeds. The different locations are like different types of earth, causing different plants to bloom or wither under special circumstances. This leads to iconic scenes like the Red Wedding, Hold the Door, or the hospital scene of Summer Cup.
Do you like what you see?
I love what I see.
Would you like to touch what you see?
Yes. Yes, I would.
Would you like to go out with me?
Yes, I would.
Would you like to fuck me?
Are you getting old dude getting grabbed by rock people? Now that I think about it, a lot of the Japanese manga industry works like that. One Piece, the most lucrative thing since Bento Box, has an end goal. Sure, it's a treasure, the most valuable thing in the world, so much that owning it makes you the pirate king. But it is so poorly defined after decades of material that we have now maybe a vague idea of its content and maybe location, but maybe not. And really, it doesn't matter, as the story is about the journey. Watching your favorite characters interact with angel people in the sky or visit the zombie island. If something gets popular, the creator is expected to continue the story, well over the original idea or even concept. What do you think when Sasuke got his red eyes? A couple hundred episodes later, we were supposed to see them saw to an arm? No, the story evolved to stay relevant and fresh. It's a strange circle, even the author gets sick of sometime. And still, Naruto's son Boruto managed to catch us again, rewarding us with a great boss fight, only to draw us in filler hell. Maybe that is part of why we consider shows like Bebop, Eva, or Brotherhood classics, because of the focused narrative, which doesn't mean there aren't episodes that are just about characters instead of the actual story. Even nowadays, if a show comes out that isn't a first season, it still has trouble rising into the same ranking for some reason. Oh, and just to tell you that wrestling is probably the greatest open form of storytelling, since the ancient birth of the theater in Greece or something. Wrestling tells story in and outside the ring, it never ends, even if the hero wins, and it makes you believe that this guy could beat this guy in a fight. And that's awesome. Not knowing is half of the fun. That is why people meet up to watch it as sort of a weekly event, like a sports game. For me, a totally bland project just in the end makes for a more rewatchable product. That is why Terminator 1 and 2 are high points in film history, and all sequels and reimaginations are really tacked on and suck. Like a billion-dollar tumor.
It might be a tumor.
It's not a tumor.
A one-and-done story takes skill, planning, and something special to become a classic. There will always be room for both approaches, and the real will filter the champs from the scraps.